We have come with some innovation. A part of the innovation is about fingerling production with the new technology called temperature shock. Temperature shock means you set the temperatures to about 37 degrees Celsius, because when fish are, when they are of 5 days old, they are neither males or females. That is where now we come up with this technology so that they can now trigger the sexual differentiation to be pure males. So this technology they have been using, there are some technologies which they have been using like the hormone treatment, but the hormone treatment have negative impact, like they are hazardous, they are quite expensive, but this new technology is cheaper, applicable to farmers, environmental friendly, and also it promotes the faster, it boosts the faster growth for the male fingerling productions. And also it is since because of the various numerous benefits of this new technology, it will make aquaculture and agriculture more sustainable and economical.
I would say that this project has been very, very important. Long time, sometimes ago, farmers used to source the fingerlings from far, from Nyanza, particularly Kibos area. For now, they can get it. The fingerlings are within their reach because the University of Eldoret, Department of Fisheries and Aquatic Sciences, through this project, is able to produce enough fingerlings for the farmers. They don't need to travel far. And the university does not just supply within Uasin Gishu. It supplies far up to, I would say, Nakuru and beyond. Fish consumption as a meal for some time in the back was not very popular. Today it is very popular. If you sample many restaurants, not only in Eldoret, you'll find fish being one of the major food items ordered for. And fish farming within the North Rift and environs is picking up, and we have seen a lot of farmers coming up for inquiries, getting information, inquiring, and actually participating in having their own fish farms.